The government's announced a three-step roadmap for Auckland to move out of level three was met with what can be described as a mixed response yesterday. From midnight, you can catch up with friends or whānau as long as it's outdoors, and it's only one other whare at a time with a maximum of 10 people. Joining us with their expert reactions, and it's with gratitude that we welcome back into breakfast, Otago University immunologist Dr. Dianne Sika-Paotonu, Auckland University modeller Professor Shaun Hendy, and microbiologist and science communicator Dr. Siouxsie Wiles. Morena, kia koutou katoa. Thank you all so much for joining us this morning. Dr. Wiles, can I come to you first? What's your reaction to yesterday's announcement?
Oh, look, I'm kind of gutted, I guess. Partly because this was a step that I hoped that we'd be taking sometime next year when we had vaccines available for all of our children and, you know, better treatments. So the fact that we've kind of been forced into it by Delta, you know, this whole learning to manage to suppress the virus rather than get to zero COVID is disappointing.
Yeah, well, there's a lot of discretion that has been put on those who live in Tāmaki Makaurau with the relaxation of the restrictions. Are we ready for these new freedoms, do you think?
Well, you know, what's really important is that they've looked at every one of them and tried to see which are the kinds of restrictions can they loosen that don't really impact on transmission. And then the fact that they're going to review this is really, really important. For me, it's about thinking about the fact that we've lost level one now. And I think New Zealanders need to get their head around what the future is going to be like, because it's not going to be like, you know, how we've had in the past.
Professor Hendy, can I bring you in here? The Prime Minister said yesterday that science tells us COVID finds it hard to spread outdoors and that the natural ventilation provided by being outside makes it hard for the virus to spread, which makes outdoor gatherings the safest option. So we know that we can meet, right? Up to 10 people, only two households at any given time. What is your reaction to the relaxation of these restrictions?
Yeah, look, I mean, what the Prime Minister has said is true. You know, outdoor gatherings are lower risk, especially, you know, when you've got good ventilation or a nice windy day in outdoor space, you know, you're just not going to be exposed to as much aerosol from the people that you're meeting with. You know, and that you know, it needs to be used with caution. You know, obviously, using masks when you can is going to be a good idea. We just have to get used to the fact now that the virus will be in the community. You know, this is going to be a long-term thing now, and we just need to get used to building in sort of basic precautions when we meet with people. And I think, yes, you know, outdoor meetings for people who've been at home for, you know, many weeks now are probably a relatively safe step forward. The size gathering limit of 10, that's actually relatively effective. That'll stop super spreading events. You know, but people have to be cautious. They have to use their common sense. And if you don't feel comfortable doing it, you know, you don't have to.
Yeah, and I think that's the part. You don't have to. So we have to be cautious, but there is still a risk, right?
Yeah, absolutely. No, we can. We will still likely see cases that result from these changes. I mean, that is going to be a fact of life now. When you go out, when you're out and about, when you're encountering other people, there's always going to be a chance now that you'll be exposed to the virus. If you're not vaccinated, the chances that you'll catch the disease, catch COVID-19, are much higher, and the chances are that you'll end up in hospital are much higher again. So this is a really a call for everybody who can to go get vaccinated.
Dr. Sika-Paotonu, how do you see the relaxation of the restrictions?
Well, kia ora and good morning, Jenny
May.
But the consequences of any premature changes, such as easing restrictions too early, given that our vaccination rates are what they are at this particular point in time, along with the adverse health outcomes that we've already seen for some of our vulnerable communities, means that the consequences of any missteps will be dire.
Yeah, so Dr. Sika-Paotonu, because you brought it up in terms of our vulnerable communities. Aren't we stacking the odds against them by relaxing the restrictions? Aren't we putting our most at risk, our most vulnerable, at even more risk?
Look, there is a high risk at this point of time, given our vaccination rates. We're a bit slow with the vaccination rollout, and we've been playing catch up ever since. And although it has been encouraging to have seen these rates improve over time, more recently, we've still got a long way to go, and we cannot give up fighting COVID-19. And I totally support what Siouxsie and Shaun have already shared about the need to be cautious with the plan that has been outlined by the government, but also that my preference would have been that the easing of any restrictions would have taken place at a time when our vaccination rates were higher.
So would you have liked to have seen a roadmap towards vaccinations yesterday, at yesterday's announcement?
Look, I would have preferred to have seen a stronger emphasis on the need to get vaccinations for Aotearoa New Zealand, and in particular, given that we still have vulnerable groups. We have our children and our little ones who still don't yet have access to a vaccine that has been approved that will keep them safe. So essentially, they are relying on us to get vaccinated and to look after them and keep them safe. But we also still have a lot of work to do with hard-to-reach groups, and we need to be approaching these communities with equity-based approaches, i.e. doing whatever it needs to take to get them the help and the support that's needed to get vaccinated, to get tested, but also doing this in a way with trusted individuals that they know and that they rely on, and in a way also that reduces barriers to people who still can't get access to the vaccine, who might not be able to get tested and need to do so.
Dr. Siouxsie Wiles, Dr. Sika-Paotonu brought up our babies there. Early childhood centres can now open up on Wednesday. Are we okay with this? Also, schools looking to reopen in a couple of weeks as well.
Yeah, so the evidence from really young children transmitting it is lower than older children. I must say I'm more concerned about what's going to happen around our primary and intermediate and high school students. You know, it's only really our high school students that can get vaccinated. So, you know, frankly, I'd like to see vaccine mandates. You know, nobody should be working in a school if they're not vaccinated. Yeah. We need to sort out ventilation. There are standards for ventilation, but they're basically not really enforced. And mask wearing. Those are the kinds of things that we need to be doing to ensure that our children are safe, because we know from the data overseas that if a teacher is infected and not wearing a mask, then they'll transmit it to the students and the students will take it home.
Yeah.
And Dianne's absolutely right. You know, I think what's so distressing about this, the approach that we're taking is the burden's not going to be felt equally. And, you know, we've seen this with who's been calling for a relifting of restrictions. It's been the wealthy and the privileged. And that's because, you know, they have access to private health care and they're not going to be as affected. And so we really need to be thinking about who is going to be left out in this and not go down that route, really.
Professor Hendy, do you support compulsory vaccination for certain occupations or even for those who are crossing our borders at the moment?
Yeah, look, I think that vaccine mandates are going to have to be used. Have a duty to keep their workplaces safe, and they'll also want to keep their customers safe. If you're a hospitality business, you don't want to be shutting down every couple of weeks because you've had COVID cases and maybe in your staff. And it's not going to be the sort of place that people want to go, you know, restaurants, bars where you can get COVID. I mean, evidence from overseas shows how cautious people will be. I mean, we know it's not going to be like our level one. You know, people don't go back out into retail, into hospitality when you have COVID in the community. So vaccine mandates, I think, will become an important tool that many businesses will want to use.
Dr. Dianne Sika-Paotonu, I've got about a minute left. We've been talking about vaccination. So remind us again about how the vaccine protects us and others.
So the vaccine keeps us safe from getting serious illness and hospitalisation, but it also reduces the viral load. So it means that if we are passing it on to others, that they don't get us sick. So look, please get vaccinated if you aren't already. Please get tested if you need to get tested. Please follow the alert level rules and help other and support others around you to get vaccinated and get tested as well.
Brilliant. Thank you all so much for your time this morning, for your expertise. Dr. Siouxsie Wiles, Professor Shaun Hendy, Dr. Dianne Sika-Paotonu, Nei rā te mihi atu ki a koutou katoa. Thank you so much for your time this morning.